Hi, it's Kim from Chatterbox Quilts. Today I wanted to show you a product I got recently called the Grip and Grip. It's from Bare Thread Designs. They're the ones who make the applique pressing sheet as well. Now this is a 12 and a half by 17 inch rubbery kind of sheet. Feels the same on both sides. You can see it's black. And what it does is it grips. Could you tell from the name? Okay, so what you put it on, it sticks to. So you can see it's sticking to my pressing board I have here right now. And whatever you put on top of it, and I'm talking fabric typically, is going to stick to it as well. So my fabric is going to stick right to it. So the nice thing about this is it's perfect for making quilt labels. It's perfect for if you want to draw your quilting motifs on your quilt top, or if you like to do hand embroidery and you want to draw out a design on your fabric first before you hoop it up and start stitching, that would work really well on the Grip and Grip as well. So let me show you, if you were going to make a quilt label, for example, I like to use pigment pens when I'm doing this. So I put my little piece of fabric on the Grip and Grip, and it doesn't matter which side, both sides are the same. And then I'm going to write on it. So if I want to say made for, let's say, I can say made for, and then I could fill out the recipient's name. So you can see how it kept that fabric very still on the Grip and Grip. So it's not distorting it and moving it all over the place, which is what you typically find happens when you don't have something like the Grip and Grip underneath it. Maybe you like to do some coloring on your fabrics, or maybe you do that with your kids. So if you want to do that, I typically use Crayola crayons to do that. You could do that on here as well. And you can see again, I mean, the fabric moves slightly because I'm pressing down on it, obviously, but it's not shifting all over the place. So you could do this, and then you could color in, let's say, a little red center on this one. I'm not an artist, but there's a little flower for you. And then typically when you do this, you want to heat set it. So I usually put a paper towel over top. You could also, if you had one, use the applique pressing sheet for this part of it. But I put my paper towel over top and I want to heat set it with my iron. So I'm just going to go over this with my iron. I typically go back and forth, right? And you want to heat set that crayon that you just used to draw the flower with in there. And so some of it usually comes off on the paper towel. Not hardly anything is coming off on this one. But the nice thing with the Grip and Grip is I can use my iron on it because you saw me do it, right? So it is also heat resistant. Now, talking about the iron and the heat that's going to be applied to the Grip and Grip, it, like the applique pressing sheet, tends to get pretty hot when you put the iron on it. So after I'm done this, you notice I'm not picking it up. I'm not taking the fabric off right yet because it's hot. So it's cooling down a bit, but it keeps that heat a bit. So be very careful after you've pressed on it when you're peeling it off. So you can take it off now, but you can see how it's stayed very still, that fabric. It allowed me to draw that little flower. It looks very nice, such as it is. And I find this really handy for any of these kinds of things. Certainly I do my quilt labels this way, and I'm always struggling to put something underneath that keeps the fabric from slipping around. So the Grip and Grip is perfect for that. Now, what do you do with the Grip and Grip when you're done with it? Well, you want to store it, of course. So you do not want to fold this. You want to make sure you roll it up, so you can roll it either way, and it would fit very nicely if you roll it this way. It's going to fit into a paper towel tube. So when you have your next paper towel, then the last one that comes off the tube, keep the tube for storage of items such as this. So you can just roll it up and keep it in there, and you'll be able to take it with you if you go places as well. So it's very handy for that. Also, if you're someone who likes to put crystals on your fabrics, this will also hold your fabric down really well when you put those crystals on, so that the fabric's not shifting and maybe you get them in the wrong place. So you can use it for that as well. It comes all rolled up in a little tube, and it says Grip and Grip on it. So if you are someone who likes to use crayons on your fabric, or you're looking for something to keep your fabric from moving around when you're drawing on it, you might want to consider getting the Grip and Grip from Bare Thread Designs. I almost forgot to tell you some other use for the Grip and Grip. If you have your sewing machine on a table and you find it slipping around quite a bit, you can put the Grip and Grip underneath it and it'll hold it steady while you sew. If you're not already a subscriber to Chatterbox Quilts YouTube channel, please do so. You can subscribe and you'll receive videos from us every single week. And also, I'd love it if you give this video a like, a thumbs up, and other people will be able to find it as well.